Coming up, action from freestyle skiing and ice hockey at the 2015 Winter Universiade in Granada. Women's ice hockey saw the USA play Kazakhstan. In the men, there was a quarterfinal spot at stake with Spain facing South Korea. And it was a memorable day in the half pipe with the first gold medal at the Universiade for France. In the women's ice hockey competition, the United States playing for pride after a somewhat disappointing group phase. They lost 2 out of 3 in the preliminaries, took on Kazakhstan at the Mulhacen Pavilion. Kazakhstan had lost 7-1 against Canada, 12-1 against Russia. And this was part of the playoffs for 7th, 8th and 9th position. The USA lost 2-1 to China, 4-1 to Japan before beating Spain. The US looking for a win here under Kristen Wright. The Kazakhs led by Alexander Maltsev. Referee for this game, Gabriela Mala of the Czech Republic. And there'll be plenty of goals in this one. Early chance for USA's Kristin Levesque. Americans counting on Amanda Abramson, Kendra Myers, and Cassandra Catlow, some of their key players. And they'll be piling on the pressure in the first period. Kristin Levesque with an early chance. Paige Harrington as well, going close early on. Good work there by the Kazakh goaltender. Shot there from Levesque. Paige Harrington going close here. Remember, the United States bitterly disappointed, losing 2-1 to China and then 4-1 to Japan. 2 years ago, USA lost the penalty shootout to Russia in the semi-finals. They won't do as well this time out. So they started really well here. Another save that time by Azin Raushanova, Kazakhstan. Still in the first period here. And Victoria Bottolussi also going close for Team USA. But on the counter, the Kazakhs going ahead. Zarina Tukyayeva with 40 seconds left on the clock in the first half. A real stunner that for the United States. That was the only scoring in the first period, and it was the Kazakhs who were celebrating. Took Tieva with that strike. Now in the second period, USA would pile forward. Kaylee Mooney denied that time. Frustrating time it was for the United States under Kristin Wright. And the Kazakhs would make it 2-0 to Meriot Rispek on the break, somewhat against the run of play. It's all about putting the ball, putting the puck in the net, and 2-0 it was for the Kazakhs in the second period. Nice play too, in off the angle. They have it 2-0, and the Americans in real trouble. They did pull one back though, Caitlin Augustin, in the second period, giving them hope. After falling 2-0 behind, Augustin, there you have it, 5:03 on the clock. And that was it for the second period in terms of scoring. Kazakhs had defended poorly against Canada and Russia. Seems with far stronger players, one has to say, 19 goals conceded. into the third period. Great effort here from Molly O'Neill. Acrobatic, but not quite enough from the American. But then look at that finish from a Hayley Williams past the goaltender Aizen Raushanova. 2-2. Delight for the Americans. And that was a superb comeback. Question, could they finish it off? 2:37. And we would go into overtime. Thanks to that goal. Good finish it was from Williams. So into overtime, and there will be a goal from Emily Ford after Madison Smiddy's shot was stopped. This still before that goal, and then there was time for the Americans here. 3-2, and the comeback was complete. Emily Ford doing the job, and the USA completing a wonderful comeback. You can see what it meant to the players. And coach Christian Wright, bitterly disappointing for Alexander Maltsev and the Kazakhs, who must have thought the win was in the bag, but they couldn't quite hold on. Three teams, remember, in the 7th to 9th placement round. And it's the USA who start with a win. Kazakhstan and USA now both playing the hosts, Spain. Remember the semi-finals, Japan against Canada and China versus Russia. But this one went to the USA. 3-2, and what a comeback it was. Ice hockey, one of the big attractions at this Winter Universiade. And in the men's competition, Spain took on South Korea in front of more than 2,500 fans. A place in the quarterfinals at stake. The hosts had hammered China in Group A, but lost to the Czech Republic and Slovakia. South Korea didn't record a win in what was a tough group against Sweden, Russia and Canada. The pressure very much on in this game then. Spain losing 5-2 against the Czechs and Slovakia. Spain coached by the Finn Timo Tuomi. South Korea under Haewoo Kim. So Spain against South Korea then, a place in the quarterfinals at stake. And this was to prove an eventful game. First real chance coming with 15:55 left in the first period. A chance for South Korea, but Dong-gun Lee denied that time. It stayed 0-0. Very quickly a goal though, and it was the wrong way as far as the hosts were concerned, with Sean Oh making it 1-0 for South Korea. Perfect start then for the Asian team, who've really been suffering in this competition so far, but knowing this was their chance to go through, and it would get better for them. 12:32 to go. Jae-jun Ha on the mark for South Korea, giving them a 2-0 advantage. And a real blow that for Spain. The hosts would have a chance. 10:46 left in that first period. Ignacio Solorzano. Not quite enough for him though. But Spain will get one back. Gaston Gonzalez getting a pass from Pablo Puyuelo. Remember Puyuelo, one of the scorers against China. And that pulled it back to 2-1. The joy was short-lived though, because South Korea restored the two-goal advantage. Gon-hee Han. Delight for the South Korean fans, seeing their men go 3-1 up. We're still in the first period here, so these supporters with plenty to cheer. Into the second period, but Spain coming back again. They showed real heart in front of their own fans. Gaston Gonzalez with that goal, making it 3-2. Spain having another chance to score. But look at this save from Jangwon Bae. He made 21 saves during the game, and he was a key player for them, Jangwon Bae, the goaltender for South Korea. South Korea missing their own chances. It was Jaejun Ha with the chance to extend their lead. South Korea on the counter here. This was end-to-end stuff. There could have been plenty more goals in what was an exciting night for the fans. Long-range shot from South Korea here from Seong Won, but it stayed at 3-2. South Korea would hit the post as well. Plenty of goals in this one. It stayed at 3-2 at the end of the second. Into the third period then. And again, a chance for Spain. They would be denied. Remember, the winner would go through into the quarters. 12:51, Juan Munoz with a great chance, but again saved by the keeper. He had a really good day for South Korea. Jorge Burgos was off the hooking, and with the power play, South Korea getting the goal. Sungjin Lee extending the advantage. Spain came back again, though, with a goal from Paulo Gonzalez, who scored two against China. Another one for Gonzalez. But that wasn't quite enough. That's how it would end. So, real disappointment for the home team, despite a near comeback at the end. 4-3 it finished. And South Korean fans celebrating at the end. So despite an 11-1 loss against Canada, 13-0 against Russia, a shootout defeat against Sweden, South Korea through, and they face the Czech Republic in the quarterfinals. Also look out for Russia against Slovakia, Kazakhstan against Japan, and Canada against the United States. But South Korea winning this one 4-3. Freestyle skiing took centre stage on Wednesday at the Sulaira Snowpark. Excellent conditions, temperatures about 3 above 0 for the fans. The half pipe back in the Universiade programme after not appearing in Italy 2 years ago. Good snow conditions there, you can see. A couple of years ago there was only ski cross and slope style events taking place, but the half pipe back at the Universiade in Spain. Half pipe length and 165 metres, 18 metres width to width. Now, those who'd failed to qualify, these are the qualifiers first. Sofia Marchesini of Italy was first to go, but she ended up sixth. Failing to qualify, Zuzana Wittich of Poland, Elena Arena Jaimez of Spain, Patricia Munoz, also of Spain, and Alexis Kini. Silver went to Elizaveta Chesnokova of Russia. She was second after the opening run, 73.6. Her score in the second run, 73.0. She was 19th at the Sochi Olympics, 12th at the World Ski Championships in Austria this year. She studies at the Ural State University of Physical Culture. And it's the fourth medal in the freestyle event for Russia. Silver medal then for Chesnokova with this performance. Now the bronze went to Jules Seifert of Germany. She was third after the first run. She was sixth in the slope style at the Universiade earlier this week. She does specialise in the slope style, so she'll be delighted with a medal here. She studies at the Albert Ludwigs University in Freiburg, and it's the first medal in the freestyle for the German team. She beat up Enya Butler of Switzerland, who ended up fourth, 56.6 and 57 for the Swiss. Incidentally, fifth went to Brooke Potter, who won the slope style gold medal earlier this week. She came fifth, and Sofia Marchesini of Italy was sixth. Bronze, though, going to Jule Seifert, 63.2 and 62.4, her respective scores. Bronze, then, going to Germany.
Su
But now let's have a look at the gold medalist. It was Marine Tripier-Mondanson of France. 77.8 points, good enough for her to get the gold. She led after the first run with a score of 75.8 points. She was one of the favourites here. Bronze medalist at the Winter Youth Olympics in Innsbruck in 2012. She studies at the Institut Universitaire de Technologie d'Annecy. 19 years old. With those two scores, 75.8 and 77.8 points. Fine performance it was from Trappier Mondanson. Fairly comfortable win for her, and it's France's first gold of these Universiade after getting three silvers and three bronzes. A gold for France, Marine Trippier Mondanson. So there's the podium, France with the gold, Russia and Germany completing the top three.
Congratulations to all of them and félicitations pour les vainqueurs.
Now the men also in action. It was Austria, two for USA, two for Russia and South Korea in action. John Leonard, he led after the first run, 81.6 points, and he really dominated the competition after that 81.6, 86.4 points. His winning score, first started the skating moguls, he was 10th in the slope style earlier this week, and it was a super performance from John Leonard, studies at the University of Oregon. Fourth medal in the freestyle skiing for Team USA. There was another American in the top six, Broby Leeds, who studies at the Westminster College in Salt Lake City, to be happy with fifth, but it was a gold for John Leonard. And the Americans. Good day for Kwang Jing Kim, South Korea. 71.6 points was good enough to get silver. He also got 62.6 on the day. He was second after the first run, 25th at last year's Olympic Games in Sochi. He's the South Korean national champion in the half pipe. And another medal for Kwang Jin Kim. Studies at Dankook University. He's going to take a silver medal home for South Korea with this performance. Now Pavel Chupa of Russia just denied a silver. His two scores, 67.8 and 70 points. He was 14th at the last World Ski Championships in Austria. Studies at Moscow State Academy of Physical Education. He beat out another Russian, Petr Kordyuk, who studies at the Siberian Federal University. Kordyuk finishing fourth. Chupa getting the bronze. And yet another medal for Russia, who are dominating these Winter Universiade.
We'll have the official results. We'll start with the Chroma Flower Ceremony of the Winter Universiade Ski.
Chupa with the bronze then, there you have it, an exciting day at the half-pipe event at these Winter Universiade. USA getting the gold, South Korea and Russia completing the podium.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.